Hi all, I'm Sarika and welcome back to my channel, Your Knowledge Buddy. Today I'm back with another new video where I'll be talking about another new visa route to migrate to the UK. This visa doesn't require you to have IELTS or any other qualification. Again, this is one of the easiest way to migrate to the UK, but you cannot settle on this visa, but you can switch your visa. So this visa is via tier 5 visa route, which is called as tier 5 charity worker visa or temporary worker visa. And someone from my audience already got this visa, and hence I thought it will be good to make this video for everyone's awareness and also to motivate you guys. Also, UK government didn't mention any kind of qualification for you to apply for this visa. So if you're interested in this topic, make sure you stick with me till the end, because I'm going to cover everything about this visa, like the benefits, eligibility criteria, what documents are needed, how you can apply, and also name of a company who is currently hiring foreigners in this visa category. So without any further delay, let's begin. This visa is called charity work visa, which means you will not be paid for this work and you cannot take any permanent work, and you should not take any public funds either. However, the best thing about this visa is that you can switch your visa within the UK. For example, say you found a new job with tier 2 sponsor company, you can apply from UK for your skill visa and also switch your visa category within the UK. Now, let's talk about the benefits of this visa. So number one, you can bring your dependents with you on this visa, like your husband or wife and children. Number two, your dependents can work full time. Number three, you can study while working. Number four, you can do a second job in the same sector at the same level as your main job for up to 20 hours per week. Number five, you can do a job on the skilled worker shortage occupation list for up to 20 hours per week, which will also be paid. Number six, this visa allows up to stay in the UK for up to 12 months, but you can extend it before the expiration date. The good news is, if you gather a few months of experience with this job, you have a high chance to get visa sponsorship for healthcare and assistant job, as your current UK experience will be counted and healthcare assistant jobs are in UK shortage occupation list. Now, let's look at the eligibility criteria and what documents are needed for this visa. So number one, you must be at least 18 years of age. Number two, most important document is your passport. Number three, you must have a job offer and certificate of sponsorship, COS, from a licensed sponsor before you can apply to come to the UK to work. The work you do in the UK must relate to the work of your sponsor company. Number four, TB test results if you're from a country where you have to take the test. You can verify this from the UK Home Office website. Also, for my Indian friends, you definitely need TB test results. Number five, proof of funds to show that you can financially support yourself while living in the UK. You can use your bank statements or fixed deposit as evidence. And you must have at least £1,270 in your bank account to show you can support yourself in the UK. You will need to have had the money available for at least 28 days in a row. Day 28 days must be within 31 days of applying for this visa. However, if your employer wants to support you financially, they need to clearly write in their certificate of sponsorship. Then in that case, you may not need to show proof of funds. Your partner and children also need to prove they can support themselves while they are in the UK. Now, let's talk about how long you can stay. You can stay for up to 12 months or the time given on your certificate of sponsorship plus 14 days, whichever is shorter. You can enter the UK up to 14 days before the start date of your job. Now, application fee. The application fee for each person applying is £259. The fee is the same whether you're applying from inside or outside the UK. Now, if you're wondering how much it costs, you, your partner or children will need to pay the application fee, pay the healthcare surcharge fee, which is generally £624 per year, prove you have enough personal savings. So you'll have to pay £285 for your partner, £315 for one child, and £200 for each additional child. Now, how long does it take? You can apply for a visa up to 3 months before the day you are due to start work in the UK. This date is listed on your COS. As part of your application, you'll need to prove your identity and provide all your documents. Now, getting a decision. So once you have applied online, proved your identity and provided your documents, you will usually get a decision on your visa within 3 weeks if you're outside the UK and 8 weeks if you're inside the UK. However, due to a delay in the visa, make sure you check out the updates on the UK Home Office website. Now, how to apply? You can apply online via UK Home Office website from this link. I have provided this link in the video description for your quick look. Now, let's see who's hiring. So name of the company who's hiring now is Larch in the UK, and this is where one of my subscribers got the job. They're still recruiting now, and just go to their careers page and apply. Also in the future, I will try to bring this person on my channel so that he can share his own experiences with you guys. Based on my discussion with him, he said he's not getting salary, but he's given some pocket money. But the best part is that you are getting free accommodation to live, and also you are getting your food. So in short, your bills are paid, accommodation is paid, and your food is also paid. So which is not bad, I guess. And if your dependent is working full time with you in the UK, you can do really good saving. So that's all what I wanted to cover in today's video. Please make sure you consider this visa category if you want to migrate to the UK. All the best to everyone, and please keep sharing your experiences with me. And also, if you got any follow-up question on this visa, you know where to write. Comment below. Thanks for watching my video till the end, and I'll see you guys soon with my next video. Till then, keep learning.